Hello everyone. Now we are going to discuss one more case which is pending, as I told in the last lecture. If you have observed till now, what we have done is we are always doing something. Either the numbers are less than 100, let's say 98 and 92, both are less than 100, or we are taking numbers like 107 and 105, 112, whatever, they are more than 100. So that means the numbers till now what we have done is either less than the base or more than the base. But we are seeing a case here where the numbers, one number is less than the base and the other number is more than the base. Let's see how we can do this. It's the same technique. 96 is 4 less than 100 and 107 is 7 more than 100. Same technique, we just multiply and we get 28. After that, what do we do here is, here 96 plus 7 we do. We doesn't do minus 7 because plus 7 is more. But see, the technique remains the same, that in a diagonal way, either we add the numbers or subtract the numbers. Or we can do 107 minus 4. And the very beauty that you can see here is, again it's all same. Like 107 minus 4 gives me 103. And 96 plus 7 also gives 103. So the answer is 10328. Is this? Let's check if the answer is that or not. 96 into 107. No, our answer is not correct. The answer is 10272. So that means there has to be some little bit modification happening here. The modification that we need to do here is basically something like a subtraction or a complement. Okay, so why we are doing this? Just see the technique first, I will explain it. We want the complement of 28. That means if I subtract 28 from 100, how much it will come to? Of course, it will come to 72. And I decrease 1 from this number. So that means this is 10272 is the answer. Let's see it again. I know this will be little confusing, but let's see it again. What did we do is, first thing we have done is 96 is 4 less than 100. Then we have done 107 is 7 more than 100. We multiplied 7 into 4, which gave me 28. Then we have done either 96 plus 7, which gives 103, or we have done 107 minus 4, which also gives 103. So we got this number also. The next step is that since both the numbers here are on two different sides of the base, we cannot just add it, or we cannot just keep it like that. Why? The answer will come in the next lecture. I'll explain how all these techniques are working. So accordingly, your questions will get answered. So just try to understand the technique now. Whatever the right side number is coming, there we are seeing that how much less it is than 28 is than 100. So which is clearly 72. And then on the left side of the number, we decrease 1. So from 3, we decrease 1, which gives me 2. So the left side becomes 102 and right side becomes 72. That's all is my answer. We can try out one more example with this as well to check how this is working out. So I'll just take one more example here. So let's say we want to multiply 85 and 105. So one number is less than 100 and other number is more than 100. This number is 15 less, that is 85 is 15 less than 100, and 105 is 5 more than 100. So the first step is multiply the right hand side, which gives me 15 5 is 75. Then the next step is either do 85 plus 5 or do 105 minus 15. Whatever we do, it comes as 90. So the next step is find how much less 75 is than 100, which is 25, and do a minus 1 from this side, which gives me 89. So the answer is 8925. Let's check this out. 85 into 105 gives me 8925. That's all. So that's all is the technique here. So this techniques are quite simple and easy to implement. You can just sum up all the techniques that we have used till now. So these things are quite simple and understandable in any form. We will sum up all the techniques that we have done till now, because it's the same technique but with little bit of modification based on the different cases. So you might have got confused. So in the next lecture, I'll sum up everything together and then we'll start explaining that how this technique works. What is the logic behind the technique?